Hello everyone, I am Luella Concepta Govius. I will cover few topics under Unit 1 and Unit 2 of Biology for Engineers. Welcome to this lecture wherein I will tell you about reverse osmosis. First, I will give you a small introduction to the topic reverse osmosis. Then I'll tell you what is the principle behind reverse osmosis. How does reverse osmosis work? The membrane modules in which the reverse osmosis membranes are arranged. Stages of different reverse osmosis systems. What are the impurities that can be removed by a reverse osmosis system? And applications of reverse osmosis. So let us begin with the introduction. Reverse osmosis is a treatment process. It is a process that is used to treat contaminated or concentrated water by the use of a membrane that is partially permeable. That is, it can allow only some materials to pass through it, whereas it restricts the transfer of other components across it. And this partially permeable membrane is used to remove the contaminants from water. The contaminants can be anything ranging from ions, unwanted molecules to larger particles. Basically, you get clean water at the end of reverse osmosis process. The principle includes forcing the water by application of pressure across a semi-permeable membrane so that the impurities are retained on one side of the membrane. And this can be used to remove dissolved and suspended particles, that is any chemical or biological particle from water. So coming to the principle behind reverse osmosis. Before you start with reverse osmosis, you should know what osmosis is. Osmosis is a naturally occurring process wherein you have a concentrated solution and a dilute solution across a semi-permeable membrane. So when this setup is present, the water will always flow from a region of lower concentration of the solute to the region of higher concentration of the solute across the semi-permeable membrane. Okay, so when does this process stop, or when does the flow of water stop? The flow of water across this membrane stops when the process of equilibrium is reached. Now, what does equilibrium mean? It means that the concentration of the solute on either sides of the system or either sides of this semi-permeable membrane is uniform. That is, when the concentration is equal, the movement stops because the equilibrium has reached. Okay, and here you can see a difference in the height. This difference is a height. Difference in the height will give you the difference in pressure across these two points. That is called as the osmotic pressure. Okay, so this is about osmosis. Now, what is reverse osmosis? As the name suggests, reverse osmosis is reverse of osmosis. Now, naturally, the water will flow from the diluted solution to the concentrated solution side. But if you have to reverse the process, what you must do? You must apply a pressure on the concentrated side of the solution. And this pressure value should be greater than the osmotic pressure. Okay, so when it is greater than the osmotic pressure, because of this extra pressure that is applied, the water which is present in the concentrated solution will be pushed to the dilute solution side. Now what happens is the highly concentrated solution, the concentrated solution becomes more concentrated because water is now removed. That will remain on one side of the membrane, whereas clear water comes to the other side. So this process is reverse osmosis. So coming to how does RO work? how do you make this process work? So here in the system, you have a reverse osmosis membrane. Generally, you won't have one membrane. You will have multiple membranes arranged in modules. Okay, so we'll see what a module is in the coming slides. So first, you have a reverse osmosis membrane module that is kept here. The feed water. Now, this feed water can be either concentrated, meaning it can have ions or it can have impurities. This is fed to this reverse osmosis membrane module by using a high pressure pump. You know that a high pressure has to be applied that is greater than the osmotic pressure. So when this happens, what happens is the water gets forced through the RO membrane across the RO membrane. So this side you have the water which has low concentration of salts, basically zero concentration of salts, which is called as the permeate water, that is your clear water. And on this side of the membrane, on the lower side, you have the solution that has concentration greater than that of the feed water, and this is called as the reject stream or the waste stream. This goes as waste. Okay, so the water is pumped across the semi-permeable membrane by means of tangential flow or cross flow, wherein the pressure is applied perpendicular to the feed flow or the fluid, the feed that flows at 90 degrees or perpendicular to the membrane. Okay, that is shown here. Coming to RO membrane modules, like I said, you cannot use one single membrane for your process. You have to use multiple membranes. So they have to be arranged in a particular fashion that is called as modules. So the reverse osmosis membranes, they are of two types. They can be made up of two materials. One is cellulose acetate material and the second one is polyamide material. So these membranes are arranged in a spiral wound module, that is the most common arrangement of reverse osmosis membranes, whereas the second type, that is a fairly uncommon type, is called as the hollow fiber or the tubular fiber, tubular membrane setup. Okay, so first let us see how the membranes are arranged in a spiral wound module. Okay, so this is how the spiral wound module looks like. So first you have a feed, okay, the membrane is folded into half. Okay, this is the leaf, it's called as a leaf, not the feed. So here the membrane is first folded into half, and in between the folded membrane you put a spacer. Okay, a feed spacer is kept. Now the membrane is glued to the feed spacer on three sides and one side is left free. And then you have a permeate spacer, which is shown here, that is attached to a central most perforated tube. Okay, you have a central most perforated tube to which the permeate spacer will be attached. Now your leaf, which is there, leaf that is made up of membrane and the feed spacer, will be glued on to the permeate spacer. And this process is repeated, that is each leaf is prepared and it is attached to the permeate spacer until your thickness is achieved, whatever thickness you want, that is achieved. The unglued side, which is there, that is kept attached facing to the central tube, and the membrane layers are wrapped around the central most tube. Okay, that is why it is called a spiral wound module. This is the construction. So now we will see the working of how the reverse osmosis takes place in this particular setup. Okay, so the first this feed which is there, it is introduced through the feed spacers. The leaves are the place where the actual reverse osmosis process takes place. Okay, so the dilute water will come out from the other side of the reverse osmosis membrane, and then it is carried through the permeate spacer. The diluted water is basically the permeate. You know that the permeate spacer is directly connected to the centralmost perforated tube. So the permeate will all collect in the centralmost perforated tube, and from there it goes out. Okay. So next is the second type of setup, that is your hollow fiber module. I told you this is slightly uncommon. So here you have hollow cylindrical porous membranes. Your membranes are arranged as hollow cylinder, narrow cylinders, and a large group of these hollow cylindrical porous membranes are enclosed in a larger support tube. Okay, so this is how the setup looks like. This is your tiny small cylindrical membrane setup which is present, and that is included or enclosed in a larger support tube. Here the flow is inside out, meaning the feed stream, which is your concentrated solution along with the impurities, they flow inside the hollow cylindrical porous membrane. Here you can see, okay, and by the process of osmosis, reverse osmosis, the permeate or the clean water comes out from the semi-permeable membrane. So all this permeate which comes out from these multiple cylindrical porous membrane setups, it will come out and get collected in this larger support tube, from where the permeate or the clear water is removed, whereas the retentate or the reject stream which is there, that flows out from the opposite side of the hollow cylindrical porous membrane setup. Okay, so this is how your hollow fiber membrane module is set, along with how the reverse osmosis takes place. So next is stages of RO system. You know that when you have a water purifier using reverse osmosis, you will not have only the reverse osmosis membrane setup. In addition to that, you will have some other filters also. So based on the number of filters that are used in a reverse osmosis system setup, you will have stages of reverse osmosis process. That is, there can be 3, 4, or 5 different stages. Okay, so your entire reverse osmosis system setup makes use of 2 types of filters, that is called as a sediment filter, carbon filter, and carbon filter, in addition to your reverse osmosis membrane filter. Okay, so in the first stage here, when you have a water purification process, you have a sediment filter. Okay, first stage, you have a sediment filter that is used to collect the sediments. And in your second stage, that is after the water crosses the sediment filter, it will get into your carbon filter. Okay, so the second stage will be transfer of water through the carbon filter. Now your third stage is the main process, which is a reverse osmosis membrane module. Okay, so after that it will again go to the fourth stage, that is your another carbon filter, and finally it comes to the clean water faucet. Okay, that is where your water is collected. That is your fourth stage, another carbon filter. So the sediment filter is basically used to collect dirt, dust, and rust, that is your larger particles in the contaminated water, whereas your carbon filter is used to separate chlorine and volatile organic compounds. and your reverse osmosis membrane module will remove up to 98% of total dissolved solids. So what does a reverse osmosis system remove, or what are the impurities that can be removed by a reverse osmosis system? So your reverse osmosis can remove dissolved salts, that is small ions, particles, colloids, organics, bacteria and pyrogens. That is, it can remove most of the contaminants. Basically, minerals and dissolved organic compounds whose molecular weight is larger than water can be efficiently removed, because water passes across the membrane. So whatever components have molecular weight larger than water, it can easily pass through. Okay, it can be easily removed. Then you have heavy metals such as lead, asbestos, radium, etc. These are all very toxic heavy metals. All that can be removed by reverse osmosis. It can also remove heavy weight volatile organic compounds and chlorinated pesticides. Herbicides and pesticides, certain pesticides whose molecular weight is lesser than that of water. You have some herbicides and pesticides whose molecular weight is less than that of water. They cannot be removed by your reverse osmosis membrane module, but they can be removed by the carbon filters which are present in your entire reverse osmosis system. You have two, that is pre and post filters. So now coming to the applications of reverse osmosis process. First is, reverse osmosis process is extensively used in the treatment of wastewater. Wastewater can be effectively treated by reverse osmosis and it can be reused. Then potable water, preparation of potable water, that is drinking water. Potable water refers to drinking water. The aqua guards or the water purifiers which are present in your homes, they will be reverse osmosis membrane module containing aqua guards or water purifiers. Third important application of reverse osmosis is, it is used for desalination of brackish water or seawater. Brackish water is water where the salt concentration is high. So it can be used for desalination, that is removal of salt from brackish water or seawater, so that this water can be used as potable water. Then it is also used to prepare boiler feed water. Boiler feed water means there are many processes wherein clean, fresh steam has to be used. Basically, in industrial reactor setup, you need clean steam for various purposes. So the water that is used there to prepare steam has to be very clean. So to prepare this boiler feed water, reverse osmosis setup is used to get the purified clean water. And finally, it is used to prepare ultra pure water. This ultra pure water is DNAs, RNAs free. DNAs, RNAs are the enzymes that can break down the nucleic acids. So this ultra pure water, which is DNAs, RNAs free, is prepared by reverse osmosis, and this can be used for various molecular biology applications. Okay, so we've come to the end of this reverse osmosis topic. Thank you.